Okay, let's do this PvP. Bam! Bam! Ups. Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of Dark Souls 2 PvP. Today I'm PvPing with the old whip, and I have to say this whip kicks ass. It's such a good weapon, and yeah, if you buff it up, it's even more powerful than it is right now. Its critical damage is comparable to a dagger, and yeah, it's just like you saw in the intro, it kicks ass. In this PvP session, I just said that I want to that I buff when the opponent buffs, and here I noticed that I have Fat Roll, but I couldn't swap it out because he ran up to me and he poisoned me. Okay, with his infinite spam. So I thought, like, you know what? Fuck you, I have the old whip and you have a buff, so come on, let's do this. You don't have anything. Boom! Wrecked. Almost. And my time's running out, but I have a katana in the offhand also. So it's a old whip katana build, kinda, but mainly old whip. So you see that damage, man? This is not a really bad ooh, his damage is also. This is not a really bad armor that he has, but the old whip kicks so ass. That's because I don't think many people like the old whip to play against with. You can parry it. It's that Mastodon Halberd backstab damage. I think it wasn't upgraded. And again, fishing for the backstab. Well, I think old whip can handle this. Also, the cool thing about the old whip are the attacks cancels that you can do with it. I don't do it in this video, but in the dueling video against Mistborn, you can see this in the end a bit. And here, this guy obviously doesn't know how to play with the thing or the with the. What is it? Red Iron Twin Blade, I think. But the old whip kicks ass. Just kicks ass. Also, the rolling attack when you roll directly away from the opponent. I don't do it in this video, but if you roll directly away from the opponent, really away, and you do the roll attack after a bit delay of standing up, then you turn around 180 degrees. And it's awesome. It's awesome. 180 degree turnaround rolling attack. I don't think that many other weapons have that. Also, the old whip might look a bit spammable. So, like, I always do the R1 because it's always a whip smash in front of me. But it's just because the moveset is like that. Also, at the spear, you can't see when someone is spamming or when someone is using it with different attacks, because it's just like that. All attacks look similar. This here was an R1, follow up R1. This now two-handed. This is an R2. That's a bit different. And also the. You see that guy with his red iron twin blade. This weapon is very common now because the patch made it that powerful. But the, like you saw here, the one-handed running attack differs a bit, and that's mainly what people use about it. But I don't think it's really to overuse. You can use it now sometimes, but I don't think it's the best attack. The best attacks of this old whip would be the rolling attack and the running two-handed attack, because it has an awesome reach. And of course the two-handed R2 of it is, it's, the damage is unreal, it's, man. And yeah, this guy has fun at throwing throwing knives and playing with his dual katanas, and in the end he's just losing HP with against the old whip. So yeah, I have to say, kinda overpowered weapon. Because yeah, it's kinda balanced with the low durability that it has, but I'm wearing the bracing knuckle ring, and so this weapon can have dual R2 without breaking. So yeah, it's not that big problem, and yeah, kicks ass. You can also swap when you parried with it, you can swap to this old whip, and here you see this, yes, in an invisible weapon, but only a greatsword, so, and no weapons to change to, so now I know what he has, and this is completely senseless, although I get wrecked a bit. So what did I want to say? Old whip, overall, an awesome weapon. It's pick it up and try it, and yeah, you can change to it for criticals and use it in normal fight really good. So thank you for watching this episode, yeah, and I see you all in the next video.